This is a tiny computer that fits in the palm of your hand. The full power of Linux. Hackable, tactile, simple. Featuring a very unique reflective memory LCD, a physical keyboard, and powered by Raspberry Pi Zero. This is Beepy. I've always been fascinated by small computers. Nowadays, we all carry with us an extremely powerful computer in our pocket. But smartphones are boring. Beepy is fun. Let's take a closer look at Beepy and the one huge flaw that it unfortunately suffers from. Having quick access to a Linux terminal can be quite useful, such as for carrying around your favorite pen testing tools, or for SSH'ing into a server for some quick maintenance. And actually, I find that I'm also using Beepy the other way around. Having it connected to my local network, I can SSH into Beepy from my main computer, and not only do various configurations more easily, but also transfer files and manage tools on the device that I want to take with me later. Beepy is also a fun little device for connecting to some retro BBSs. Although since the screen is only by default a 50 by 30 character display in black and white, you will have to find BBSs made for older computers without a lot of ANSI graphics. There is a command line application for most things you would want to do in Linux. Do a bit of programming, check the weather, or go on IRC and chat all day. Or we can have a bit of a silly time, generate some ASCII graphics, have a train drive by, and get some good advice from a cow. Or maybe even play a game of Zork. The great thing about Linux is that everything is possible. If you can imagine it, you can script your way out of it, or find that someone else probably already has a solution up on GitHub. You can also connect USB devices, such as an RTL SDR or Wi-Fi adapter, or just use it as a cool clock. Let's take a closer look at the hardware of this device. The Beepy hardware is open source and is made by the small company SQFMI, which they say is an abbreviation for Square-O-Fumi, whatever that means. Beepy runs off a Raspberry Pi Zero that mounts on the back of the device. You can either run a custom slimmed down OS specifically made for Beepy, or you can run regular Raspbian. Once you've flashed Raspbian Pi OS Lite to an SD card and booted it, you will need to SSH into your Beepy and install the driver packages for the screen and keyboard before they will work. It's fairly easy, although I had to choose the legacy version of Raspbian to make it work. The screen is the same one as you find on the odd handheld game console called Playdate. It's a non-backlit black and white memory LCD. It has a fast refresh rate and uses very little power, but you need a light source nearby to see anything. It brings back nostalgic memories of playing my old Game Boy as a kid, even if it is slightly frustrating at times to have no backlight at all. It looks crazy good in sunlight though, I've heard. By default, the screen supports only text, but you can fiddle around with some experimental code and get it to render some graphics and even load an image. There are also attempts at getting other graphical software to work. Someone is even working on porting Palm OS to Beepy. The keyboard is an old BlackBerry keyboard, like you also see on a Lilygo T-Deck. It's very tactile to type on for its size, and the response is fast and accurate. You use the Alt button to access the symbols printed on the keys. Press Alt and Enter to do a tap. There are additional symbols available by using the symbol button, but you will have to look them up on the Beepy website. Pickup call is mapped to control. The Barry button activates meta mode, which gives you access to a few more shortcuts, like turning on the keyboard backlight or moving the cursor around. By default, all the modifier keys are sticky, so that you don't need to hold them down if you don't want to. Little icons on the top right indicate which modifier keys are currently active. The back button is mapped to escape. The touchpad in the middle can be used to move the cursor if clicked once. The hang-up button is used to gracefully shut down the system by holding it for 5 seconds. All the key mappings are configurable. There is also a programmable color LED and a button on the side, but I have not yet managed to figure out how to interact with them. Beepy doesn't come with a case, so I've 3D printed this one. As of recently, you can also buy a clear case on their website. There is, however, a huge problem with this device. Well, actually, there are several problems, but let's go over the big one first. The 2000 mAh battery lasts for about 6 to 8 hours, which is great. You can print this variable to get the current battery percentage. But what is not so great is that for some obscure reason, they've chosen to limit the charge current to 100 mA, which means it takes at least 20 hours to charge the battery fully. This is way too slow. Another big problem is that they've used a boost converter chip that apparently is known for randomly self-destructing. If this happens, it makes it impossible to power Beepy from either the battery or the USB connection, effectively killing it. And there's been several reports of this occurring. And maybe this is why you can't actually buy a Beepy at this moment. I'm sorry if I got you all hyped up for it. Beepy was launched about a year ago and quickly went out of stock. SQFMI has teased the launch of a version 2, supposedly in early 2024. But as the making of this video, there is still no news. I hope it eventually releases and fixes the problems. I know it would be an instant buy for me. Hopefully, they can still source these awesome old BlackBerry keyboards. Until then, if you really want a Beepy, I will link a Discord below that you can check out. Someone is manufacturing small batches of a modded version of Beepy with a very cool looking color memory LCD and a faster charging circuit. I think Beepy is extremely cool. This powerful little platform has a huge potential for custom software and hacks. I love that it's tiny, simple, text only, and not a touchscreen, even if I would like the option of a backlight occasionally. I hope I've given you a small insight into what Beepy is all about.